The old dictator, very close to dying, could barely walk, supported by a cane. His housemaid could hear him deeply sighing as she approached the bed where he was laying. Later, as he saluted his banner that was hanging slack and tired from its pole, from the balcony that overlooked his manor, he could feel that in his chest there was a hole. And at noon the guards could hear him talking to himself. And though the day was very warm, he had put on, before he went out walking, his fully decorated uniform. Moving closer, you could hear him saying, "I have served my country very well. In fact, so well our whole world should be paying me and my deed a deep respect as well." He shouted, "Our whole world," like he was fussing with someone, and he doubted his own mind when he loud and clear could hear some horse flies buzzing. Our cow, while swarming round the cows behind. From all around a gentle voice was rising, a female voice, so very deep and sound. "Child, you're very close to realizing it really is the other way around. Your world," she continued, full of laughter, "boy, very soon now you'll be forced to see. If not before your final breath, then after. You are dead, that really you belong to me."